Good morning, guys. This might be one of the most random videos I've ever made, but it's October and I'm on a random ship in Sweden. Good morning, guys. I'm in Sweden and I'm on a ship. So this is the A.F. Chapman ship, which is located in central Stockholm. It was actually born and raised in Cumbria in England. Its original voyage was from Cumbria to Oregon, and then it made lots of trips all around the world, like Australia and Europe. And now it's a youth hostel that has 280 beds, so highly recommend you stay here. It was such a cozy sleep, and I took this picture when I woke up this morning, and I just love being on the water. It's just so calming. But yeah, I'm gonna get some work done this morning, and then I have a full 2 days exploring in Sweden, so I'm so excited. And yeah, give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel if you're new, and let's go explore Sweden together. Look how beautiful this hostel is that I'm staying on. Like, how amazing is that? Okay, so I'm gonna give you a quick little room tour. So there is 4 beds. Now on Hostel World, you can pick between staying in the building or staying in the ship. So make sure if you're gonna stay here, pick the ship. I think it's the second option down below, I'll link it. But yeah, had a really cozy sleep. I think there's like 6 beds in here. And this is my bed here. And this is the freaking amazing view I woke up to. Like, but that is just sweet as fuck right now. And then this one was open all night, but it actually wasn't surprisingly cold. Like, it was a really nice temperature. And then you have mirror over here, some little hangies. Alice is just doing some work. And then they have lockers here as well. The showers were really nice. Like, bit of a morbid thought, but like, I feel like the hallway reminds me of like a scene in Titanic. Like, obviously the ship was built like over 100 years ago, and even in the showers, like, I could just imagine myself like showering there 100 years ago. It's really weird. But yeah, we are gonna go do some work and then go explore Sweden. Okay, guys, so we have just stopped at Nespresso House, which I think is like the big chain of coffee out here, and literally got a falafel wrap, and look how enormous this coffee is, literally like the size of Alice's head. Like, they do not do them this big in England, but yeah, I'm gonna chow down and do some work because this looks yummy. Okay, so this next place we went to is a popular meatball place in Sweden. It's called Meatballs for the People, and it just kept coming up when we googled best meatballs in Stockholm. They do a vegan option, but it was nothing to write home about. Good morning, guys. I am in Sweden. This is the second and sort of last full day because we're going home tomorrow. I didn't really vlog much yesterday. We just kind of explored the old town, so I definitely recommend doing that. There's some really pretty buildings, lots of nice places for coffee. Today we are going to the ABBA Museum, which I'm so excited about. Did you even come to Stockholm? If you didn't visit the ABBA Museum, we're just gonna find a little spot for some breakfast and then head to the ABBA Museum. I'm so excited.
Gimme a man at the midnight.
Somebody. Loz is getting ready for ABBA.
What, kids? Are we ready?
Where are we?
ABBA Museum.
Whoa, that was really close. Oh my god, guys. So we have just arrived at the ABBA Museum and we are so excited. I think it's about £20 to get in, so we're going to buy some tickets. We just took some funny pictures, but we've been singing ABBA the whole way here. I am so gassed to be here right now. This is so cool. Oh my god. So this is the car from the movie that you can get a picture in. Well, it's not actually the car, but...
Yes.
Should we do it?
It's off on our wedding day.
Oh, it's us.
It's me and Dane.
I mean, she does not look happy, does she?
Only one person at a time. Oh, yeah.
So this part of the museum is very cute. It's basically when ABBA went to Brighton and won Eurovision for the song Waterloo, and they've got the outfits and the diary entries. Like, it's so adorable. I love it.
Hello. This is ABBA speaking.
A stage. This is amazing. Wow. Does that mean we get to perform? Can we go on stage?
Mamma Mia, maybe?
That was so much fun. Highly rated. I think I would look good in the orange. Probably.
I think I'm in the red because there's a lot of cleavage.
Oh, actually, I've got a speedo this colour, so.
Yeah, so you can get. I've got that for the cleavage.
Yeah, and Alice, do you get left with the orange? I feel like you suit orange, Alice. Mm. We're just picking out outfits. So apparently they have the Mamma Mia the Party restaurant in the O2 in London, and as soon as this whole pandemic is over, I definitely want to make a trip there because it looks amazing. But you're basically like part of the set and part of the movie. And I'm so there for it.
This is cool.
Oh my god, all of their outfits. I want all of them. And their records. I just can't imagine wearing any of these clothes, but I totally would because it'd be so much fun. What is it? Okay, I'm game. Our next Halloween outfit. So the ABBA Museum was actually iconic. It was very interactive, lots of like dancing, like lots of photo ops and lots of information. I just wish I was alive in the time that ABBA was like a big thing, because I just absolutely love it, and we've just, yeah, it was so much fun. Definitely check it out. It was like, I think it was about £22, and you can buy tickets when you get there. It's actually closed on Mondays and Tuesdays. Sweden, y'all. Oh my god, Alice. You little bitch, you tried pushing me in. So I think I've decided that I want to move to Sweden, so I'm gonna have to learn Swedish. But everywhere is so beautiful. One of my erratic life plans. The people are beautiful, the food are beautiful. It's a little bit expensive, but we can get a good job doing something. Do you know what? Doing something.
I don't really know what the jobs are like out there.
Yeah.
I mean, the fact that Raz is basically a builder.
Really? We could do that.
We saw a lot.
We're just walking around and getting a bit lost, and we've just found this random tiny house. I'm wondering if anyone actually lives in there. We have just strolled amongst the most beautiful photoshoot area. Like, this literally looks like you'd have your wedding here. Like, it's so nice. Future husband, if you're watching this, we're getting married in Sweden. This high street brand are really stepping up the sustainable game with the world's first in-store loop system. I just so happened to be in Stockholm the weekend they opened this part of the store. The system uses no water and no chemicals, thus having a significantly lower impact when producing garments. Essentially, you can take in an old garment like a jumper and they can knit it into a new unique piece of clothing. They do add some sustainable virgin materials to make up the whole garment. The sustainable factor is amazing. I love the idea of recycling old clothes into something new. If you're ever in Stockholm, check this store out. I'll leave the details below. I assume and hope they start putting these in H&M's around the world because I really do want to try it. Okay, so another thing you need to do when you come to Stockholm is come to the tiniest alleyway in Sweden. Like, look at this. So this is actually how skinny it is, and you can see from the top. I will literally put all the details in the video below so you can find this alleyway. Literally, it's just like an old town and you've probably walked past it loads of times. It's been so refreshing to be here in Sweden where it just doesn't feel like the pandemic exists. So Sweden haven't really done the same thing that the rest of the world has done. You don't have to wear face masks here. They do have a few signs about social distancing, but it's not really enforced. Again, in bars and stuff, like, you can just be as close to people as you want, and it just made me feel really normal and just really nice. There is so much uncertainty at the moment in the world, and it's just been such a lovely break to come here to Sweden. It's just really interesting how they have dealt with the pandemic, like, they've just continued as normal and everything seems absolutely fine here. I know some people might think it's a bit controversial to visit Sweden. I'm a UK citizen. We are legally allowed to visit Sweden at the moment and we don't have to quarantine on arrival. My trip highlight has been the ABBA Museum. If you come here, make sure you go to the ABBA Museum because it's so good. Like, oh my God, I want to go again. I would definitely be returning to Sweden. I would love to see more of the country and more of the Scandinavian countries. Stockholm is such a small city. It's got a really good vibe. It would be nice to have another couple of nights here just because I really enjoyed myself and I could just honestly stay here for longer. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button as well to see future videos and also give this video a thumbs up. I really appreciate it. I hope you've enjoyed this Stockholm video. It's been a bit random and all over the place, but yeah, come and check out Sweden. I've definitely loved it and I'll be back again. I definitely want to go to like Gothenburg, but Stockholm is the capital, so I thought I'm going to start with that. And yeah, it's just been a really cool vibe and I love it. I also look really crazy, like I've been out all day. Who are you gonna call?
Ghostbusters. I'm gonna call my mom. 911. Screaming. It's so nuts, guys.
Madness, isn't it?
BTS. Oh my crazy. God, save me.
I work for VX.
Save me, Loza. This is pretty fucking narrow, though.